meet Ray Linwood Poland. Hi, how are you doing, Ray?
Fine, thank you, Natalie. Welcome to Frogmore, South Carolina.
Well, thank you for having me. You know, I am just really amazed by your story, but really your artwork with coastal sculptures. I mean, you do something really unique because we see a lot of paintings on the wall. We see, you know, all kinds of sculptures and things like that. But you do a 3D artwork that's really unique in itself that represents this area like nothing I've ever seen.
Well, basically the art, the wood come out of old boats, shrimp boats that have been jettisoned in the creeks, and you can see some in the background. And what I do is take the wood out of the old shrimp boats, process it down, and it's my memory growing up on boats is how docks look on the east coast of the United States, southern shrimp docks.
Now, Ray, you're not new to this area. Now, most people around this area know you as Linwood, and I'm calling you Ray, but you're not new to this area. You grew up here, have quite a background. I mean, your classmate was Pat Conroy.
That's correct.
You're a Vietnam vet. You have quite a background, and you went through kind of a hard childhood, but this is what you know. And you were a mechanical engineer for 30 years?
30 years of mechanical engineer.
But now you kind of grew up on shrimp boats. Is that what gave you the passion to kind of, you know, start doing the artwork so later in life? Because this is not what you did early in life.
Never thought about doing art in any concept anyway. I've always been creative, but that passion went into sales. Never thought about doing art until I retired.
Well, you can definitely do art now. You were actually thrown out of art school years ago, which is kind of funny to me when I see this incredible artwork on the walls. I mean, the shrimp boats are incredible to look at.
I was attending a school in Savannah, Georgia, well known, and after about 3 months of classes at night, the professor pulled me to one side and says, Ray, you need to look at art as a recreational outlet. And I knew he was right because I couldn't draw a straight line. And what I did was, coming back, it didn't upset me, but I stopped at Walmart and bought a glue gun. And I had a friend to carve out a shrimp boat. And I always collected driftwood. And I did my first piece.
But Ray, how do you come up with something like this? I mean, you just wake up one day and you create something unique and special that's so symbolic of this area, you know? I mean, it's just incredible. I mean, how do you come up and see that vision?
Well, it's a talent that, you know, you don't know you have. You one day wake up and you just start. It's like everything, you just start doing something. And believe me, I had as many failures as I had successes. So I just would put one together and it didn't look right, I'd take it apart and try again until somebody came in, bought a piece and said they liked it, and I said, well, I know how to improve on it. And I've probably gone through 10 generations of my art.
You use this as kind of a healing process, and each piece that you do is totally custom. I mean, they're one of a kind and totally custom, right down to the names of the boat. And that's what really makes this unique, I think. But you use this as kind of a healing process for yourself.
Well, that's correct. Think about this, Natalie. It takes 100 years for a tree to grow as tall as the wood that they use in shrimp boats. The shrimp boat works for 40 to 60 years. It's provided a living for a family. It goes down, put it in the marsh. I'm fortunate enough to go out and cut the wood out, go back and process it, build a piece of art. It's gonna be in family for years, another 40, 50 years. So it's a spiritual thing to me about a piece of wood. And it kind of reflects on my life. No, I didn't have a happy childhood. Left home when I was 14 years old. And through the years, the healing process started with a lot of help from a lot of people. So now it's never too late to have a happy childhood. If you decide you're gonna do something and you have enough passion about it and you can vision what the finished product is gonna be, you can do it.
Well, Ray, I am so inspired by you. I'm so inspired by your work and your passion, you know, with your life and this industry with shrimping and the life that you've lived. And now you're passing it on to so many, so many people that can enjoy it. And you know what? You're keeping it alive. And I'm so inspired
by
that.
And being a salesman, take some home with you.
That's right. Well, we're going to tell our viewers how to do that. Thanks so much
Thank
for
you,
joining
Natalie.
Us.
Thank you, Natalie. Nice to meet you. And
if you'd like more information on coastal sculptures and these beautiful pieces of artwork, all you have to do is go to the information you see right there on your screen. Now, you can purchase these pieces through TR Marketing. You'll find that information right there on your screen. Make sure that you take a look at these pieces. Get one for your home. If you know someone who owns a business, maybe a restaurant, I can tell you these pieces are so unique and special to this area, you'll be glad you did. Remember, it's TR Marketing and coastal sculptures.